Rappers couldn't last in my trenches. The wrath of my vengeance drafted through the dramatic craft of my sentence. I'm a bastard with endless disastrous limits. Sporadic maniac rapper matched with a chemist. Basically, I'm saying that to say I'm pretty good. But it's like when two business people go their separate ways, but they're still, you know, okay with it. It's like Puff was giving me the heads up. You know, he gave me like an insider, you know, basically to like the future of the direction that he was going in. And, you know, the whole thing with Bad Boy and Interscope. So it was just like the biggest insight I could have got. Like, oh, he gave me an inside, like, trade tip. Like, okay. So he just, it just gave me instruction to how to move from that point. That's why when people just thought it was something bad, I was just like, no, it was an amicable split. And that's all it was.
Where are we now?
Shit, I mean, we closer than we ever been. Like, that's big bro. But I'm just with RCA, and he's still an influence over me. And I'm on his new single that's about to drop. You know, I helped him with, you know, in part with things that he needed me for on his album. You know, and he helped me structurally, even with this whole God Money war. Because if you think back, like, Puff always talk about walking with God. You know, that's him really that was on that higher frequency. You know, and me learning, like, not trying to please people in the moment. And go and just turn up and help you turn up. You know what I'm saying? We'll get to the fun when it's time, but right now, let's walk closer with God, because like, if you wonder why some people are so blessed, you know, it's like they've been doing God work. You gotta do a little bit more of that if you want like that extreme blessing.
Oh no, I'm out the west side. Just ask my grandma. I used to move the pack, had a pack of blammer. My nigga step with AKAs and ain't no cap or gamma. And now we laughing to the bank like nana nana nana.
And it was crazy, like the other day we was at we went to Rite Aid. We needed to grab like little lotions and little mouthwash.
Hold on, tell me, you and Puff walked me in the Rite Aid.
No. I was here.
Oh, okay.
With the crew, you know. And we're getting little stuff. So there's this lady. So I said to the homies, I said, bro, let the lady go first, man. You know, so, you know, the lady, she's like, thank you, little foreign lady. So she go first, and she paying for her stuff. So then we put, like, we got, like, $100 worth of, like,
toiletries.
Little miniature stuff. So we pouring all the stuff on there. So all she had was, like, a soda and, like, a candy bar. So I tell the lady, like, man, I told the guy, I said, ring it up. She was like, no. I said, look, man. I said, we bless because we bless others. I said, those blessings come back tenfold. You let me buy your Canada Dry, we get a whole case. That's how our blessings work. This is the irony of it. We had all the money, but 12 cent.
She had the 12 cent. Did you understand what he just said? It's somebody out there, they got 12 cent if you help them out. See, don't let that go over your head.
See, that's the whole flip, man. And you got to do things without wanting things in return. You got to do them out of the kindness of your heart. You never know, that might be the person that's going to help you.
She just happened to have a dime and two pennies in her pocket.
Man, she had a bunch of change.
Oh.
And then I really took a look at her, and she just looked rich. Like, she had on these diamond earrings that was crazy. You know how, like, the Gucci link necklace is made?
Mm-hmm.
It was like that whole, the one that's made like a shell. It's like shells connected everywhere. She had earrings that was like that, dog. But they was just covered in diamonds, like the whole earring. And then she had the bracelet and the whole thing with the Louis and the Louis. And I really started looking back, like, she probably owned a whole bunch of stuff. You know what I'm saying? So she really might have been the plug, to be honest with you.
Right. You know how that shit go.
Yeah.
But basically, you was just trying to get her the hell out the way with her little one, her little Snickers bar and her Canada Dry, because like, she was in the way.
To be a gentleman, like, we all rushed the thing. And I was like, nah, man, let the lady go. You know, she got one little thing. It's like, let her go. And then I was like, oh, man, I could pay for that. You guys got a soda and a candy bar. Like, because she was like, looking for the exact chances. I was like, man, ring it up. I told her. She was like, no. She was so humble. And then we start paying. And we was 12 cents short. And then she had a 12 cent. That's how that thing worked. That's it. And then this dude, right, who came after her, guess what this nigga purchased? This white guy.
A blow dry.
No.
What'd he get?
One more guess.
He got a some brute.
Nope.
No, it wasn't brute.
Brute.
He got some magic shave. A wave cap. Some big razors. Some blue star ointment. Cause you don't want to pay for that yourself.
Oh my God.
You want to get somebody to go in there and pay for that for you.
Yo. Nah, so the white dude, right? He had on a suit, man. This nigga had two economy size boxes of Trojans.
Fucking forever.
And some bleach. And I said, bro, let me tell you something. I don't know you. But you have the greatest purchase in the history of purchases, bro. You got two big, like, 50 boxes of Trojans, right? They was humongous.
What state is this?
New York.
This is in New York?
This is in Manhattan.
Whoa.
And you got a thing of bleach. I said, so, nigga, you getting ready to do laundry. You getting ready to wash them sheets, nigga, ain't you?
Yeah.
Like I'm just adding. I was like, he bust out laughing, man. He didn't want to laugh, but he had to laugh. I said, that is the you winning tonight, bro. Go clean shit and have sex.
Oh, my God. He must work for Bang Brothers or something.
You clean. Yeah. That's what it was. That was a Bang Brothers purchase, bro.
Yeah. That was definitely a Bang Brothers.
Only thing on Bang Brothers, man, they ain't using no condoms.
No, they not.
And they might not even be using bleach.
No. That's how you burn the disease off with the bleach.
Yeah,
and
you just pour the bleach on
it. Whoa. Yeah. Shit. Yeah. Have your shit sizzling, but it's gonna be clean.
And just a teaspoon of Palmolive.
Yeah, a teaspoon of that.
Just a teaspoon of mm-hmm. that. You know what I'm saying? And you gotta soak a four leaf clover in some milk.
Yeah.
For 3 days, and chop up some garlic, man.
That's the cure.
Drink that.
That's the cure. That's what Magic Johnson did, and that's why he all right now.
But you know what? How ironic that his name is Magic Johnson.
Yeah.
Leave it alone.
Leave it alone.
Leave it alone.
Come on, man.
Hey, that's some magic in that Johnson.
It's some magic in that Johnson. Make you live forever.
Yeah, that's crazy.
It'll make your son gay, but it'll make you live forever.
Shout out to Magic Johnson, man. The legacy, though, man.
Yeah.
Like, mm-hmm. Dude did it all, man.
He did it all.
He did it all. I got a lot of respect for that guy, though, man.
Yeah, me too.
He a big-time owner. You know, he's just a dope. He got a dope perspective on the game still. Like, he ain't get old and start to get bitter. And you know how they get old, like, Scotty Pippen.
Yeah, he's very
bitter. They start saying belligerent things, like, certain people are better than Michael Jordan. How could you ever say that? As Scotty Pippen, look, Jack, I don't care what nobody said. I'm not never saying a nigga better than you.
Man, I appreciate that, dog.
Even though there are so many people.
It was so many motherfuckers that got me beat.
On the way here, I gave change to a guy that I know got more potential than you.
Mm-hmm.
And I would never go on record and admit that he better than you. That's between me and you.
And that's why I fuck with you, because you help people.
You know what I'm saying?
Because you know I don't need to hear that.
Yeah.
Because you know what it's going to do to my mental. And have me all belligerent later on, and now I'm gonna be out on the street. And,
the fact that you could have easily been in the lower percentile.
Mm. Easy.
Just life.
Mm. Mm.
That's a blessing that we just gonna keep a secret.
Mm.
And let's just pretend that you are the best.
Mm.
Cause that's what I do, Jack.
Hey man, I like living in denial.
They say, you're going to see Jack. I say, I'm going to see the best. We call you the best.
Right. Now you was like, no, really? I'm going to see Jack.
Right. But I'm like, he's the best though.
Mm.
Cause we got to tell you that. And downstairs, before you come up, they say, tell Jack he's the best or he'll kick you off. He'll kick you off the show. So.
And how many minutes have you been here thus far?
You're the best. Put it right there.
Right there. Okay.
No, put it there. No,
not like that.
That was invasive.
I'm sorry.
That was invasive, Jack. Put it there. Now lock it.
Oh, there you go, right that way. Okay, gotcha.
Lock it up. You see that?
You brought yourself down to my level.
Let me tell you something. Never go here with it, because that's intrusive.
That's intrusive.
Mm-hmm. That's a bit much.
Mm. And so even if I told you that was some new shit, that's some shit that don't need to be new.
That's like rock. That's like paper cover rock, the gay version.
Yeah, right. Yep.
If somebody did that as a youth, and they said, you playing rock, paper, scissors, and they covered your whole, and they did, you know what they going
to. Yeah, they trying to.
You know what they going to do later
they
on.
They're trying to cover your rock.
You know what's going to happen. Woo!
Now that's hard. Word.
Bars. They trying to cover your rock.
Yeah. Got that hustler's desire, that fire burning. I got that voice in the hood, miss with that high get learning. Nah. Niggas is bugging, niggas ain't fucking with me. They not on my planet, why should I panic? Motherfuckers should be. Do you ever make bets with Diddy?
I usually bet with him.
You bet? Oh, you always, yeah. That makes sense.
He's not usually wrong.
right. That is.
That nigga said, we was watching a Bradley Pacquiao fight, and that nigga said, the black man gonna win.
Get the fuck out of here.
Bro, listen to me. We in his crib, we watching the fight, and he's like, mind you know how that fight was going.
It was going not in the black guy's favor.
Puff stood up and said, he was on the microphone at his crib, because he had a big fight party, DJ and all that, and he said, black man gonna win. And we was looking at him.
Puff helped fix that fight, didn't he?
Listen.
Because you know that shit was fixed.
Listen.
Puff knew what the...
He said black man gonna win, dog. We go to the decision.
Okay.
And we all sitting there waiting for them to say the opposite. And they lift up Bradley's arm, bro. And that nigga Puff ran around that house and said, I told y'all, don't ever doubt me. So I said, okay. You special, nigga.
Why he don't ever respond to 50 when he be going at him?
Because I think it's like an admirance thing, man. I think everybody loves 50. You know, I think at the end of the day, I mean, everybody got love for 50. Like, how you don't love 50, man? You know what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, you still gotta respect where somebody came from, what they went through, and what they created. Because the same way 50 Cent respects that and Puff. Like, the only reason 50 do that is because Puff set the mold for a 50 Cent. He set the mold. You know, the whole New York thing, they got so many things in common. I mean, for 50 to go from rap to making the successful business moves, that type of shit come from Puff. Not to say that Puff hand taught him, but he laid down a blueprint for, like, yo, this music is one thing, but look how we moving. Look how we can move. For 50 to even have those thoughts of wanting to do it like that, it comes from the Dr. Dre's, the Puff Daddy's, the Russell Simmons, the, you know what I'm saying, the Rev Runs. It just runs deeper. And, like, to me, 50 Cent is a person who respects that, because how could you do it and become that and not respect it, because you are that now. I thought the thing was funny with the skit and the thing he did.
He told the nigga he couldn't leave. You know, I just realized why I don't like that nigga Puffy. He gonna go bail that fat nigga out. Nah, no more Puffy juice, no more Bel Air. Who the fuck drinks sparkling wine anyway?
You know, I find the humor in it, man.
That's worse, like terrorist worse, because the rap mogul is now being accused of making terrorist threats during the fight at UCLA.
Puffy? Terrorist? Nigga, Puffy is in the UCLA campus jail right now. Yeah, nigga, shit got real with the coach. We got to go get to him. Yeah, man. You know how shit go. Yeah, man. They said Puffy went Savant Coco on the coach with a kettlebell. All this shit started since Drake, man. He be wanting to fuck everybody up. Yeah, man. I'm counting the bail money right now so I can get him. Before he fucked me up, I'm scared to death around here.
Right.
You know, we know what 50 do. Marketing genius, man. You know, I think the biggest thing I think I like about 50 Cent is that he gave his homeboys $1 million record deals. You know what I'm saying?
That was amazing.
That's amazing.
Hey, man, you done figured life out, baby.
I'm figuring it out.
Word.
I'm figuring it out.
Yo, is there anything you want to say to Thisis50 before we get up out here?
Yeah, shit, I'm coming for everybody. You know, I think about
you coming for the number one spot.
I'm coming for the whatever's better than number one. That shit don't even excite me. You know, I want something better than that shit. If all y'all wanted to be number one, I want whatever's better than that shit. But at the end of the day, I say this to say that I'm inspired by all y'all, man. I don't give a fuck about the state of hip hop and what people are saying about the music industry, nigga. You just gotta be different, walk different, talk different. You gotta live different. You just gotta have a whole different approach about your shit.
Thank you, Los.
Yeah, man, we out here.
We out here.
Yeah.
Don't kiss them hoes in the mouth unless you got to. Pow.
And some of y'all got to, man.
Some of them got to.
Oh, no, no, I'm out the west side. Just ask my grandma. I used to move the pack, had a pack of glamour. My niggas step with AKAs and ain't no cap or gamma. And now we laughing to the bank like Nana.